Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Aarti Agrawal. I'm working as a cataract and a refractive surgeon at Agrawal Eye Hospital, Malad and Sanjeevani Eye Hospital, Bhayandar. So I'm going to brief you all a little about LASIK. LASIK, also known as laser in situ keratomyelitis, is the latest breakthrough in the laser vision correction. So what laser does is, it basically reshapes this black portion of the eye so that you get freedom from glasses. So a few facts about LASIK. LASIK is not a surgery, it's a procedure. Patient does not need to get hospitalized for it. One eye takes only 3 minutes, so altogether 6 minutes and the procedure is done. There is no eye injection which is involved. Within 10 minutes you have complete freedom from glasses and one can easily go home and do all the basic activities from the very next day. So coming to the part that who is eligible, how do you know whether you are eligible candidate for laser or not? So first of all, for girls after the age of 18 years and for boys after the age of 21 years, this is basically when your number becomes stable. So one main prerequisites for laser is that your number has to be constant for at least 6 months. The question comes is how much LASIK can correct, that is what refractive errors does LASIK correct. So LASIK can correct that is minus number, which is also called as myopia, of about 0.5 diopter to minus 13 diopter of spherical power and 0.5 diopter to minus 6 diopter of cylindrical, that is astigmatism. Whereas when it comes to hyperopia, that is plus number, LASIK can correct to 0.5 diopter to plus 7 diopter of spherical power and up to plus 5 diopter of cylindrical. Laser is most beneficial for people who are not tolerant to contact lenses. What contact lens does is it causes dryness, allergy, and it even leads to further infection in the eye. So for such people, laser is a boon. It basically gets them freedom from glasses as well as contact lenses. Apart from this, some professions like actors, some professions like Navy, Army, these demand for 6x6 or 20x20 vision unaided, that is without glasses. So now comes the question as to how this laser surgery is performed. LASIK essentially involves 3 steps. The first step is where we create the corneal flap. The second is where we deliver the laser. And the third is repositioning of the flap back. So in the first step where we basically create a flap, this flap can be created with the help of a blade, which is a microkeratome. It's a microsurgical blade which we use. And it can also be created with the help of a laser, which is also called as femtosecond LASIK. The step 2 basically involves reshaping of the cornea with the help of a laser. This basically is programmed in the machine based upon the patient's or based upon your eye power. The third comes repositioning the flap back. Basically, after the laser is delivered, the flap which we had created in step 1 is repositioned back to its anatomical position. So few things when you decide that you want to undergo LASIK is that consult an ophthalmologist, get your glasses power checked. There are few tests which we do before we decide whether you are eligible for LASIK or not. That's basically called as corneal topography. To summarize, LASIK is basically a safe procedure which involves quick, fast recovery. It gives us immediate results. There are some patients who are not eligible for LASIK. For instance, for people who have glass power more than minus 13, who have very high refractive errors, for people whose cornea is thin. So these are kind of people who are not suitable for LASIK. But there is nothing to worry. We have an option. We have an option for everything now. There is a latest technology which is called as ICL. That is implantable collamer lens. These lenses are specially designed for such eyes. It is something like a contact lens which we place over the eye. A similar kind of a lens which is permanently introduced inside the eye so that you have complete freedom from glasses. So I would just say that the advanced technology has an answer for everything. So everything is treatable, everything is curable, provided that you want to undergo the treatment.